Jane, it's tax season, and your group is trying to shed light on the tax differences between couple seniors versus single seniors. What is it that you would like to see that would level that playing field?
Well, we're tiptoeing into our recommendations, mostly because as I say, the government is so reluctant to take away anything. So if that's the case, then we're looking for ways to begin, then not to come up to the level of the couple immediately, but step by step to get some tax breaks for ourselves. We're saying, well, we have three or four different suggestions. Number one, and this was one we proposed last year, if a single person has a taxable income of 30 of 100,000, make the single person only pay tax on two-thirds of that. So in other words, 70,000, for example. So that's one tax break. Another one would be a $25,000 tax credit for anybody who is a single senior. A third one would be when we get to the portfolios, we want the right to choose a beneficiary who will get directly the money that we have in our portfolios, TFSA and RRSP or RIF, directly. We want the same rights as the couple has. So in other words, the right to shovel that money upon our death into the choice, our choice of beneficiary, to go into the very same portfolios of that beneficiary directly.
The federal government will be tabling the budget in the coming weeks. Do you think that some of your proposals will see the light of day?
Not directly. Here's what I know so far, and maybe there'll be no reference to anything that we want. We've been at this for about 3 years, trying to get attention and so forth. We're very much connected to the finance committee that meets regularly and so forth. And you may be aware of this, that about a week or 10 days ago, they put out a 226-page report that was read in Parliament and then handed over to the Minister of Finance with all their recommendations. If you access that report, you can see recommendation number, I can't remember whether it's 114 or 115, says that the discrepancy in taxation between single seniors and couples should be looked at. That's all. And so one more study, and we know what happens to so many studies. Nothing concrete.
As you wait for that step, what are some of the solutions on your end as you see them immediately?
Well, I mean, those two or three ideas that I mentioned, I mean, that's really what we're after. Another one, and this is always a matter of dispute, but the whole thing is that a whole lot of single seniors are renters. And they are gradually losing ground. I mean, all kinds of them are being turfed out of their apartments, and they end up for the same money that they're spending on rent in some basement. Or some of our supporters have made compromises and are living with a partner who they don't even like particularly, but who happens to own a home and will charge less rent and so forth. I mean, the homeowners are, as we all know, are sitting pretty. They're just gaining daily by doing nothing, whereas the renters are facing a higher and higher cost of living. And between those conditions in terms of the price of accommodation and the high taxes that were charged, because we need two-thirds of the income of a couple to maintain a similar lifestyle. That's just a known fact. But we are being so harshly treated that we are gradually, although we are mostly very much middle class, we are gradually being shoveled down into the poverty class.